Hey, happy Wednesday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. Now, Francine is going to be making landfall later this afternoon. Also seeing a little more consolidated where this eye is going to be, the center of the storm. And you can see it with all the ensembles. It is taking just a little bit further of that eastern track. Also is becoming a bad case scenario. It's still getting hit with that dry air and that shear, but it's still going to strengthen all the way down to a low-end Cat 2 hurricane, and then weaken to a high-end Cat 1 right before landfall, maybe even stay at the last second a low-end Cat 2. Not seeing no major hurricane. It's going to be a major enough anyway, but you do see it is taking that little eastern push. And also what that means, as this comes on shore, all this banding, not only the chances for the tropical tornadoes that's going to come out of this, all the storm surge is going to be pulling right into this direction. So anywhere from La Place around to Kenner, especially on the western side of Lake Pontchartrain, this is where the surge is going to start building up and where your biggest amounts could be on your storm surge. Plus, as this goes later on through this afternoon and tonight, still bringing the chances for the tornadoes as it comes on shore, and especially for southern Mississippi as well. Now we're already looking at 11 o'clock. Now we're going into midnight. Overnight storms moving through Jackson, still a strong tropical storm on a weakening trend though. And then that's when you got the chances for the tornadoes for southern Alabama as well. And then later after that, it just keeps moving further north up Mississippi into Tennessee all the way to the next morning for a Thursday, and you still have the threat for tornadoes kicking all the way for Alabama, going to the panhandle of Florida as well. So what I'm going to do is show you some information real quick. That way you can see what the latest findings are on this Hurricane Francine. Not showing a major hurricane is going to happen. I'm showing it's going to be strengthening throughout the day today, but I'm also showing it's going to still be on that weakening trend right before landfall. So it's going to be a little tense watching this all the way up until landfall. Now we'll get in another update before landfall, before the power outages start getting really massive for y'all, trying to give you the latest information before everything happens. Now when I narrow this down to see which weather model you really want to try and go by, because it's a little unpredictable of what's going to happen, you can see right now as of 5 a.m. it is 90 miles per hour by National Hurricane Center. Matter of fact, 92, I do believe. And you see that the Euro actually has it all the way down to 75 miles per hour winds. So I'm not believing the Euro. The Euro is keeping it where it's just maintaining that low end Cat 1 all the way across. It's believable with the shear and the dry air. However, it is getting itself together with the core, and it's only going to affect the southern side. So it's still intensifying a little bit. Now, when you go by the hurricane models, Hurricane Analysis Forecast System A right now has it at 109 miles per hour sustained winds. And that's only at 4 a.m. By 7 a.m., it has it all the way to 106. So this one is already overpowered of what is going on with National Hurricane Center. So as we go to Hurricane Analysis Forecast System B, as of right now, it's showing 110 miles per hour. So this one is incorrect as of the current strength also. So all this intensification it shows later, this one actually shows 127 miles per hour sustained winds. Do not believe this model. This model is not what's showing true. The H-Wharf model, the older hurricane model, actually is showing the same intensity that it is right now. And you can see as it goes further towards shore, it does still strengthen all the way to a weak Cat 2. 96 will put it right at that Cat 2. Then it weakens right before landfall back down to a strong Cat 1. And then it tries to strengthen back up again right before landfall, right to a strong, the strongest you can be on a Cat 1, round the edge of a low-end Cat 2 again. So it is going to fight that shear as it gets towards landfall. It's going to strengthen, then it's going to fight that shear, fight that dry air. It's going to weaken, and it's going to strengthen again potentially. Either way, it's not going to bring much more winds from that high-end Cat 1 to a low-grade Cat 2. You're still looking at potentially anywhere from 95 to 105 miles per hour sustained winds on impact that greatly weakens down within 3 to 6 hours. Still bringing a lot of high winds past that. You still got the 70, maybe even the 80 miles per hour wind gusts and a lot of 50s and 60s that's going to go all the way up Mississippi and portions of Alabama also. But you can also see on the H-Wharf that as it goes all even along, it tries to intensify. It could even try and do an eyewall replacement. That's why it intensifies, weakens, and intensifies again. So it could get hit while it's getting that eyewall replacement. That would be great. That would give it the best chance for the shear and the dry air to weaken it down greatly before impact. So I will update you again this afternoon. But you can see all day long while it's missing that southern side of the storms around the center because it's getting hit with that wind shear, it's getting hit with that dry air coming in the southern side of it. And then it goes right towards landfall, a little bit further to the east. And you can see that banding coming in right towards New Orleans, right towards North Shore, then right towards Mississippi as you go through the evening. Latest intensity guidance shows this as well. So anywhere from a Cat 1 hurricane on a slow strengthening because of dry air and the shear to your worst case scenario, maybe a low end Cat 2. So either way, the winds are not that much different because after you get impact from this storm system, it's going to start weakening down. Those very high winds are going to calm down to a Cat 1 strength, which is strong enough, but it won't stay on that Cat 2 too long after impact if it does stay that strong. But you do see it does stay a Cat 1 hurricane for the next 12 hours after that. Then it's a tropical storm for another 12 hours after that. Plus, information has changed a little bit with your storm surge and your rainfall. So I'm going to go through that real quick, and I got some information I want to show you. You see the tropical storm warnings are out in all this blue all the way across towards Alabama. You even got the hurricane watch going all around New Orleans. But you do see it is 90 miles per hour moving northeast at 10 miles per hour right now. So it's moving pretty fast. Storm surge have changed as well. You still got another 1 to 3 feet that still could happen over here along the coast of Texas and southwestern Louisiana. It has gotten better over here for Lake Charles. You still got the 3 to 5 feet right along the coast, but you can see the 5 to 10 feet is now for Vermilion Bay and going to eat by Port Fouchon. And you can see you do have that 4 to 7 feet still sitting there. So you still got that system coming in sometime around this way. And then you got all that storm surge that's going to be pulling into this direction. You do see it did change all the way from 2 to 4 feet going all the way around for Louisiana. But once it gets around southern Mississippi, it expands from 4 to 6 feet, then 3 to 5 feet. Then it goes from 2 to 4 feet for Mobile, Alabama, and all the way to 1 to 2 feet all the way towards the panhandle of Florida. Latest rainfall amounts does show it's still going to go all the way up on that block and still bring that 2 to 4 inches and all this dark green. Matter of fact, that block is still going to be here. And while we get the remnants from what's in the east pack with what's with Francine is still getting pushed out towards the east coast. Now, this high pressure up here is going to move over here along the northeast. So as this moves over towards the east coast, this is going to push it back inland with all that tropical moisture. Won't have much time. Maybe a tropical depression will form right there. It's just going to bring y'all rainfall. But at the same time, you can see right here for Francine, all this yellow, this is all 4 to 6 inches of rainfall expected. It's not your storm surge. This is only for the rainfall bringing you the flooding. And you have the 6 to 8 inches. See, it has gone down 6 to 8 inches. You also got pockets over here and a pocket of 6 to 8 over here as well. So it has gone down a little bit. You even see that the 8 to 12, not really getting on shore, maybe right on impact. And that is it. It's not spreading too far. So that has gone down a little bit. Tornadoes, you still have the 2% and the 5% for today. It has gone a little bit further towards the east. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for the tornado threat for today. But also overnight into tomorrow, you have that 2%. It has grown to that 5%. Also, chances for tornadoes, you see it has moved further to the east. Now you got Georgia in on it. So here's your cities and states at risk for the tornado threat for tomorrow, for Thursday. This is overnight tonight into tomorrow. Now remember, I have this link in the description so you can zoom in and see what your wind gusts are so far. And you can see the high 80s, even the high 90s, that's kicking all the way going towards Hammond almost. So all the way from Baton Rouge, all the way towards New Orleans, Houma, all the way to Intercoastal City. This is where a big portion of the impact is going to be. Houma, definitely need to be aware. You're on the eastern side, Morgan City, you definitely need to be aware. But you also can see that when you look with the icon, it shifts a little further towards the east. So it could be a little bit more of a shift. Remember, the trend was a crazy turn. They don't have too much more on the ensembles. So I'm thinking more of that eastern ensemble rather than that western ensemble will be the location. And that will bring further impacts, especially towards Houma, Morgan City, New Orleans, Port Sulphur, places over here on the eastern side of this system. And you also can see it does go all the way up towards Mississippi, all the way into Alabama. Even the icon shows that a little bit further to the east and shows that those 60s carry even further. So beware, this is going to be a strong storm as it comes on shore. But you can see on your vorticity that after it comes on shore, you still get the high pressure block that moves over. Now you get the high pressure over in the northeast. So it's not going to be no northeast storm, but all the remnants is getting pushed with that front to the east, and then the high pressure brings it back. So from this going this direction, this going to this direction, it's getting a little spin up right offshore, but it runs out of time because the high pressure pushes it back on shore. And this could be bringing y'all some more rainfall over here, especially for the Carolinas. When you look with the GFS, you can also see it is trending that it brings something weak right there. And I do mean weak. It's not showing that it has time to do any kind of stupid strength. This will just bring you some rainfall with that. And you can see this with the Euro. So after you have the initial impact from Francine, after it goes over, high pressure brings it back, and this brings more rainfall from Virginia and the Carolinas. Matter of fact, look what they just added over that system right off the East Coast. Not showing that it's going to be anything tropical just yet. This could be just a bunch of nothing, a bunch of rainfall, just like I just showed you. No other information has changed as far as what's going on with Francine. Everything is still the same. They just threw this in there real quick. The next big update from National Hurricane Center is going to be around 11 o'clock. But as of right now, by the time it gets around 1:30, that's when it's seen is going to be almost at its peak of intensity of 98 miles per hour. This is going to be a very low wind cat 2, 121 miles per hour wind gust. So the banding that you're going to be feeling at time from this storm system revolving around, while it is strong, is going to be some strong banding. So don't just think the winds are just going to be strong on the landfall. While this system is powerful and strengthening up all the way to 1, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, the banding will be strong as well. Then that dry air gets on the southern side of it with that shear and tries to weaken that back down. But remember, it fights it. It weakens, it strengthens, it weakens, it strengthens. It's going to fight it all the way towards landfall. But you do see that little bit of that eastern ensemble is pretty much the one it looks like it's going with. I hope this information has helped you understand what is going on with this storm system. If it has, please consider other family members. Please consider just hitting that like button down below. If you have time, please hit that share button to help other people see this information. I appreciate it so much. I pray to all of you will be safe during this time. I will upload again early this afternoon before this hits on landfall and try and bring you the latest information before power starts going out. Now, before I go for today, Psalm 124. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now many Israel say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us, then they had swallowed us up quick when their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our soul. Then the proud waters had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord, who hath not given us as a prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken, and we are escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Amen. God bless you all. Keep you all safe during this event. I will see you early this afternoon. All my prayers go out to you. Please check on your neighbors and please check on the pets. If you are in this path, you are in a trailer, a RV, that will not work. You need to get to a shelter and get there quickly. God bless you all. May you all be safe. Now remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always pray he keeps you safe every single day of your life, and especially through this event and every single one that is around you and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hold tight. Watch for your neighbors. There'll be things that you can do here and there to help another person. Be that light. Help that person, because you will need help as well. God bless you all, and I'll see you this afternoon.